And Bangor, not Banger. I've been told that many times. Bangor.
I figured as much. I didn't want to be the guy to break it to you.
No, it's good. I just got back from Louisville, Kentucky, where they get very upset if you call it Louisville.
Really?
Yeah, even though the entire country, if you tell them, how do you pronounce L-O-U-I-S, they'll say Louis or Louis. But if you go to that area and you say, how do you pronounce L-O-U-I-S, they'll say Lul. Huh. Right, because there's five L's in that, sure.
Right, because it just makes sense like that.
Yeah, same thing with Boise, Idaho, not Boise. Boise.
Boise.
So, yeah, so there's a few parts of the country where the rest of us get it wrong, but so it's fine. All good.
All right, well, again, Brad, I just wanted to say thank you for taking the time to speak with me. We'll just get right into it. So you are scheduled for later this month. You're going to be stopping in Bar Harbor, Maine, which I know is the dream of every comedian who travels.
They told me I would never play Bar Harbor, and I'm proving the critics wrong. Yes, July 25th, I believe, at the Criterion Theater. Never been to Bar Harbor, so I didn't know how much I would sell, or as people, I imagine, from the area call it, Bar Harbor. But we pretty much sold out the first show, so we added a late show. So if you're listening to this and you're like, oh, I'll get tickets to the late show. And that one's the more fun one anyway, because then I have no limits. I can go as long as I want. I can talk about whatever I want. Get tickets to the late show.
Have you been to Maine before? You said you've been corrected on how to pronounce Bangor. So yes, I assume at least a couple times.
I've been to Bangor, and I've been to, I believe there's a Portland, Maine.
Yeah.
Is there a Portland? Yeah. I've been to Portland, and I feel like I've been there every week because my wife is obsessed with Maine Cabin Masters. So that accent is drilled into my head.
Yes, sir. You can't get there from here, Jimmy.
Yeah, it's really interesting because it's, you watch that show, or I have a friend who lives in Maine who just literally just posts Instagram posts of her backyard, and like that's her entire Instagram feed. And you're just like, you watch enough of it, you're like, I should move to Maine. it looks like, I don't know if there's too many more beautiful places on the planet than Maine in like summer and in early fall, because wow, you got it's pretty stunning. Every time you make a 45 degree turn, it's just a different postcard.
Yeah, the way life should be, we say.
Ah, good for you guys. That's right up there. And you guys are right next to New Hampshire, and they got my next favorite slogan, which is live free or die.
Yeah, they're a little more hardcore than us.
A little more extreme.
Yeah, we're for sure. A bit more lackadaisical. I'm glad you brought up, I had no idea that you had so many connections to Maine like that. In your last special, Starfish, you talk about how each state has its little special thing.
Yeah.
What is then Maine's little special thing to you?
Wow. Cheap lobster. That's for sure. You guys have cheap lobster up there. But, you know, it's kind of that New England drop the R part of the accent. But the Maine accent to me as an outsider, I don't know if this is true or not, but you get a little bit of that Canadian accent that kind of bleeds into it. So, like, Boston's a little more aggressive, and then Maine is like it's still dropping the R, but it's a little more just kind of pleasant. It's nice, you know. So that would be like your guys' thing. But then, yeah, just a general, like, I feel like parts of New England have a more aggressive attitude, whereas Maine people, everyone I've met is just very laid back. I don't know if I'm wrong. I don't know if that's just I've met the wrong people, and there's some people watching this or listening to this right now going like, oh, no, there's some hardcore a-holes up here. But but for the most part, everyone seems a little more relaxed, which that's what I want for a comedy show. So when people buy a ticket to see the show, I hope they're relaxed. But we're going to have a lot of fun. I'm going to say a lot of words that I'm not allowed to say on this particular airway. But we are going to have a blast.
Yeah, that's awesome. Speaking of that show that you got coming up, I mean, you had Starfish that came out earlier this year. Are we working with a whole new set? What's the material looking like?
Whole new set. So, because I get this a lot, people go like, oh, I don't want to watch Starfish on YouTube because then it'll spoil the show that you're coming with. And it's like, no, different show. So it's a different show. I'd feel awful if I released a special and then people watched it and then they come, they buy a ticket, they pay for a babysitter, they buy a couple of drinks, and then they sit down and hear the same thing that they could have just heard on YouTube. So no, it's different material. It's been going great. And the thing about this is I'm going to a lot of different parts of the country that I never thought I'd be in. I never thought I'd be in Rockford, Illinois or Terre Haute, Indiana. But I've been there now, and now I'm going to add Bahama, Maine to that list. And I'm shocked, though, because I did a little bit of research in terms of, I'm like, wow, does anyone else come to Bar Harbor? Yeah, a lot of people do. I was shocked. I was like, I'm going to be the only gig in town. No, you guys got Post Malone. You guys got one of my favorites, Tyler Childress is coming. I don't know why I'm plugging other people's shows, but I am. So you guys are getting plenty of entertainment up there, and I'm happy to be associated with that lineup. Slightly less tattoos, face tattoos than Post Malone. But
it's not too late.
Yeah, but still, being a dwarf, if I'm walking down the street and Post Malone is walking down the street, I don't know what you stare at first, the face tattoos or the little person. I don't know what draws your eye in. We kind of look like a traveling circus at that point.
No, you bring up the new material and everything. I know you said in your first special that as a guy with dwarfism, when you're writing jokes, you're not really writing jokes. It's just kind of be you and wait. Is that a lot more of your new material with this set?
Yeah. Step one, be a dwarf. Step two, wait. That's how I write my jokes. Literally, we were on tour. I don't know if this is a part of my show yet, but just something funny. I'm on tour and my opening act is a comedian named JB Ball, who's a great comic. Please watch his special on YouTube. It's called It's My Privilege. And we were in New York City, and a guy yelled across the street. I'm walking down the street with JB, and he yells across the street at me and just goes, "Yo, I haven't seen you since prison." Now, there's a lot of people that thought he was yelling at JB because they're racist. But he was yelling at me, which just made me think, how is this large black guy? I've never been to prison. So he's thinking that I was the guy that he was in prison with, but he seemed really happy to see me. So now I'm like, oh, this very large black man was friends with a small white dwarf in prison. Where's that Hallmark movie? How did the friendship come about? Like, did the one guy drop the soap and the dwarf caught it? How did that? I have so many questions about how they could be friends. I need their story told. So that's just an example of like how I'm just living my life. I'm just going to get breakfast with my buddy, and then just material just comes at me. And
did you say anything to him?
I believe I yelled back, "I don't think I'm the guy." And then he yelled back, "Nah, you the guy." And I was like, okay, I don't. He yelled back, "Nah, you the guy." And in my opinion, I'm like, I really hope these two did not have a very intimate relationship, because if they did, my life is going to change dramatically. So I don't believe I'd be able to object to anything that he desired. But thankfully it was okay. He eventually got closer and realized I wasn't the guy, but I still want to find out. Also, how did a dwarf go to jail? I need to know what judge looked at a 4-foot man and went, "Yeah, prison, you need this." Like, how bad did that have to be, whatever he did? So that's the kind of stuff that happens. That's the kind of stuff that I bring to the stage, and I'm looking forward to bringing that kind of new material on stage, the Criterion Theater in lovely Bahama. It's going to be great. Bahama.
All right. Mm-hmm. Just a couple last questions for you. You got an amazing energy on stage. I mean, even now, just this conversation, you're up and moving.
Do
you have a pre-show ritual? How do you keep that energy on stage? What's your motivation?
You know what? My motivation is just my ADD, man. I get really bored myself. If it's just, I can't just stand still and like just do the same jokes. And but like, I got to move. I got to switch it up. I got to talk to the audience. I got Like, I get bored, I get distracted. So I don't want to be that comic that just stays still or just tells the same jokes for 10 years. You know, I'm up there doing Bill Clinton jokes or something. It's like, nah, I want it to change. So that's how I get that energy. That, and if you, this is also my first theater tour, and a lot of these theaters have 1,200, 1,400, you know, some 2,000 people. If you can't get a buzz from 2,000 people staring at you, clapping, laughing, cheering for you, whoo, check your pulse. You might be dead. So that's how I maintain my energy.
That's awesome. You know, you said in your last special, Starfish, and I'm sure you still hold a similar sentiment, that you're not exactly a fan of the news. So just out of curiosity, if yes. you were a news director, if you were in charge of a newsroom, how would you improve it?
Honestly, make every show like The Daily Show. Make every show just the spoonful of sugar that helps the medicine go down. I feel like a lot of news gets locked into one particular perspective. Like, I would love to turn on Fox News one day and just have whatever host who's on that news go, Trump was wrong on that one. And I would love to turn on MSNBC one day and just have them go, Biden, not great. Like, I would love, because I think more people would trust news if they had, if they were less dug into whatever side that they're going for. And then if you were able to criticize any particular side any number of times, I just want a news organization that doesn't have an agenda, that just tells me the news, and then I can make up my own opinions. That's me. Some people like having their opinions reaffirmed and validated, and if that's you, all right. But that's how I would change it. More Jon Stewart. Just make John. Can we AI clone Jon Stewart just on every one of these networks? That's all I want. Just AI clone Jon Stewart. Do a Tupac hologram, but of Jon Stewart, just on every news network. It'd make it so much more palatable.
All right. Well, getting back to your upcoming performance in Bahaba, as you say.
Yeah.
What can people expect? What should they know? Obviously, as a comedian like you, there's not a lot of things that are off the table.
Correct. Just know that if you're watching this interview, there's sort of language barriers that I have to abide by. And I have to make sure that, you know, y'all don't lose any sponsors. So, yes. So just know that those language barriers do not apply at the live show. It's a lot of fun. I'm not trying to gross people out. I'm not trying to anger people. I'm not very political. If you don't think that I'm going to go on stage, just talk about one particular side or agenda the whole time. My goal is always for absolutely anyone and everyone to be able to come in, no matter what their background, where they live, sit down and forget about the world for a few hours and just laugh. And that's how my opening acts are as well. So yes, high energy, some swearing, and also just know what's going on in the news. There might be a couple of Hawk Tua references. You never know.
All right. Awesome, Brad. Well, I don't want to take up too much of your day off. So one last question. Is there anything else you want to talk about? Anything that you think should be discussed or mentioned?
Oh, man. Someone bring me a lobster roll.
I think we can arrange that.
I just want one. It's cheap as hell up there. So it's like, now you come down here, they're like 30, 40 bucks a freaking lobster roll. So someone just bring me a good cheap lobster roll, and I will never stop coming back to Bar Harbor if that's the case.
All right. Sounds good. We'll see what you can do. Well, thank you again, Brad, for your time. I really appreciate it. Hope you have a great rest of your day.
Awesome, man. Thank you very much.